It was her beloved husband, John, who first introduced Swamini Alice Coltrane Turiyasangitananda to yoga, Eastern spirituality, and Indian music. In 1969, while still grieving her husband, she met Swami Satchidananda, Gurudev. She explained, "I was introduced to Gurudev by a friend who went to the Friday lectures in New York. I went to hear him and was highly impressed."
Without peace in the mind, we can't give peace to the outside world.
My proximity to him developed from the programs and the music, which was what I felt I could offer to him. In 1970, at the Integral Yoga Institute on 500 West End Avenue in New York, she received mantra initiation from her guru. Another devotee initiated at the same time, recall. Alice and I were seated opposite each other, and even though she was a big celebrity, she sat cross-legged on the floor with the rest of us. She never asked for special treatment. Such was her great humility. Swamini traveled in India with Swami Satchidananda in December 1970. She recounted, "Before leaving for India, he gave me the name Aparna, one who undertakes austerities, a name of Goddess Parvati. During this pilgrimage, she traveled to New Delhi, where she offered music during a conference in which Gurudev was a speaker. Before reaching Rishikesh and the ashram of Sri Swami Shivananda, Gurudev's guru, they took in the beauty of Mussoorie.
The ashram is so unbelievably beautiful and filled with an intense vibration of deep peace. One could almost hear the voice of Swami Shivananda.
Hari Om, Hari Om, Hari Om. Children of light, there is no virtue higher than love. There is no treasure higher than love. There is no religion higher than love, because love is truth and love is God. Love, prema, and bhakti are synonymous terms. This world has come out of love. This world exists in love, and this world ultimately dissolves in love.
A documentary about the pilgrimage highlighted special experiences in Rishikesh, including hatha yoga on the banks of the Ganges.
About 15 miles up the Ganges is Vashistha Guha. Here Swamiji leaves the cave where he has meditated many times.
At this sacred spot, Swamiji helped us all to plunge into the icy cold waters of the Holy Mother Ganges River. Worshipped by millions, this river carries with it a positive purifying vibration. It is considered as a blessing to even touch its holy waters, and we felt an undeserved and unfathomable blessing to enter her in Swamiji's presence.
The pilgrimage continued in Sri Lanka, then Ceylon, with a cultural program that Swamini participated in, followed by a yoga retreat led by Gurudev.
Real truth is expressed by silence and understandable by silence.
We were even more surprised to find that things went on as usual, even the karma yoga, and we all became much stronger in self-discipline.
Okay, friends, thank you for joining. Wish you a very good trip. Take this peace and joy with you all over, wherever you go, and share it with one and all.
And this pilgrimage would be life-changing for her. She said, "Having made the journey to the East, a most important part of my sadhana has been completed." From 1970 to 1972, her incredible creativity flourished. She explained, "The trip to the East gave me the spiritual motivation to come out more to do more with my music. I also listen to a lot of beautiful sitar and veena music, and I'm going to use some of the chants I heard, some of the essence of the East. She wrote on the inside of the album cover, "Direct inspiration for journey in Satchidananda comes from my meeting and association with someone who is near and dear to me." I am speaking of my own beloved spiritual preceptor, Swami Satchidananda. The gratitude she felt for all she was receiving from her guru overflowed. Swamini quietly donated money toward the down payment on the Integral Yoga Institute's current building in Greenwich Village. Her great humility always inspired us. In February 1971, a benefit concert for the new IYI was held at Carnegie Hall with Swamini and two other students of Gurudev, Felix Cavalieri and Laura Nero, performing. In early 2024, Impulse Records released Swamini's magnificent performance from that concert. The summer following that Carnegie performance, Swamini joined her guru and artist Peter Max on a trip to Chicago, where they appeared on an NBC TV talk show, and with Felix Cavalieri, generously performed another benefit concert for the IYI. Swamini said that it was her guru who helped her cope with pressures she faced in the music industry. She explained, "Detached doesn't mean disliked. It just means that I don't want this project to consume me. It will, if I allow it, and I can't sleep at night, because that's all I'm concerned about. So I will go and do my work objectively." That's one of the best lessons I've learned that he'd taught us. After opening her California ashram in 1983, and over the many years before that and since, she and Gurudev maintained a close connection. Here she is in 1993, chanting bhajans with Gurudev and devotees at Satchidananda Ashram.
So we'll chant some bhajans, and we won't keep Swamiji up late because he's traveling tomorrow. So we'll chant together now. Tanna Priyakara. Shiva Shiva Shambho Tandava Priyakara. Shiva Shiva Shambho Tandava Priyakara. Dhamma 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 Natanamanda Hara. Satyam Shivam Shambho Maheshwaram. Satyam Shivam Shambho Maheshwaram. Satyam Shivam Shambho Maheshwaram.
Would you like to chant a bow?
She shared in an interview, "He was a great person and a great yogi. He gave the best lectures and he was very universally minded. I didn't seek any spiritual guidance from anyone else after him." She also noted Gurudev's teaching that truth is one, paths are many, is one of the highest teachings, and we can be open-minded, universal, appreciative of all cultures and traditions, because we're all speaking the same truth. No matter what name you give, whatever term you use, we are speaking that peace, that truth, which is God. Swamini joined Gurudev during the Temple of Understanding's 1998 Juliet Hollister Award ceremony in New York. He had been one of the three recipients of this award when it was first given in 1996. She gave a generous donation in support of the temple's interfaith work and Gurudev. Her son Ravi and her granddaughter also attended. In remembering her guru, she said, "My life is blessed. I have the highest and greatest esteem for our beloved Gurudev. It was a privilege and honor to be with him. His spirit is with us, and I believe will always be with us. He is a great guru, teacher, and spiritual leader. I will always remember his divine teachings, his dharma, and the many blessings that he bestowed upon all of us. I will always share the consciousness of his light. I will carry that within me always." A year before her passing, her financial support of the documentary Living Yoga, The Life and Teachings of Swami Satchidananda, made that film possible. That film and this tribute is dedicated to Swamini Alice Coltrane Turiyasangitananda Ji. And we will always carry her radiant spirit in our hearts. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.